who was the heaviest professional wrestler of all time. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Short Shots, and thank you very much for watching. The heaviest wrestler of all time was not Andre the Giant, Haystacks Calhoun, or Gorilla Monsoon. It was 802-pound William Cobb, who wrestled professionally as Happy Humphrey. This segment was recorded December 17th. With that being said, let's go back to the final week of 1960, 58 years ago. The 10-2 Eagles defeated the 8-4 Green Bay Packers 17-13 in the NFL Championship game at Franklin Field in Philadelphia. It was a rags-to-riches tale for both teams, who had gone 9-14-1 and 8-15-1 over the previous two seasons. But on this day, Philadelphia trailed 13-10 when fullback Ted Dean ran 5 yards for a winning touchdown with 5:21 left. After the game, both Eagle backs Buck Shaw and quarterback Norm Van Brocklin decided to retire. Second-year coach Vince Lombardi would never lose another NFL championship game while taking the titles in 1961, 1962, 1965, 1966, and 1967. The Eagles never won another NFL championship game or a Super Bowl until last year. Also in 1967, the Packers reached Super Bowl II by beating the Cowboys 21-17 in the NFL championship game in the ice-strewn turf in Lambeau Field in Green Bay. The temperature at game time was 13 degrees below zero, the coldest for any contest in NFL history. Trailing 17-14 in the final offensive drive, Green Bay took over on its own 32 with 4:50 to play. The Packers drove to the Dallas 1 yard line and called their final timeout on third and goal. With 16 seconds left, most everyone expected a pass because a running play would likely run out the clock. But coach Vince Lombardi called for a quarterback sneak, and Bart Starr barreled over the goal line for the winning score, earning a trip to the Coliseum to meet the Oakland Raiders in the NFL-AFL championship game before the name of that game was changed to Super Bowl in 1968. Happy and healthy New Year, everybody, and do not forget to stay loose.